In this video, we will try to understand Levy's flight using numerical example. So here, step by step, we will try to understand how we can calculate Levy's flight using numerical example. So what is Levy's flight? How it works? We already discussed in different videos. For example, Levy's flight is also used in cuckoo search algorithm. So when Levy's flight is used in cuckoo search algorithm, cuckoo search can efficiently explore the solution space because Levy's flight combine both longer jumps and short movements that allow algorithm to search both locally and globally. It also help avoid the search getting trapped in the local optima because here the long jumps can take the solution out of local optima and it would be easier to find the optimal solution. So there are many advantages of using Levy's flight in optimization algorithm. This Levy's flight and how it is used in cuckoo search we already discussed in previous videos. So in this video we will try to understand how each step in the Levy's flight is calculated and we will use here a simple numerical example. So about Levy's flight, as we know, it is also known as Levy's motion, that is a kind of random walk. Levy's flight are the random walks, but instead of normal hops, they involve bigger jumps and sometimes along with smaller ones. And a special type of probability distribution is used to describe these jumps, that is called stable distribution, which has happy tails. It means there is higher chance of extremely larger jumps compared to normal distribution. Levy's flights are found in different areas in animal foraging. They use mix of random searching and occasional flights to find food. In financial markets, where the price movement in the stock market can display these jumps. And third one, in the search algorithms, they are used to design the algorithm that can efficiently search large space. For example, they are used in the optimization algorithms. Now you can see the basic equations that we will use in this algorithm for the step size calculation in the Levy's flight that already we discussed in this video with more details. Here you can see U and V values. They are drawn from the normal distribution and here U represent random jump and V represent here the random direction and s, small s, you can see here the step size, and s naught, that is the smaller step size. So this is the Levy's step size calculation. Here you can see this beta, that is power law index, and this value must be in between 1 and 0. This parameter is used to control the distribution of step size. When we have higher value for the beta, it means smaller steps. When the beta value is lower, it means we have the larger steps. So here you can see U and V. These values are normally distributed. And for that, first we will calculate sigma U using this equation. So for more details about Levy's flight and about these equations, we can check these videos. Here everything we discussed in details. Now we will try to understand how we can calculate Levy's flight using numerical example. So first we will initialize the important parameters. So here you can see input parameters, we have small n, that is the number of steps we will take in the Levy's flight path. Next we will decide the dimension. So here we have the small m that represent the number of dimension, that represent number of dimension means it is 2D, it is 2-dimensional, 3-dimensional or other. Then we have beta value. So beta value is used to control the distribution of step size. So here this is the power law index and value must be in between 1 and 2. Then we have output parameter, that is small s. Here it represents the final step that is calculated. So this is the step size we will calculate. So first parameter value we have 2 because we will calculate 2 steps. Next we have the 2-dimensional space. You can see value for m is 2, it means we are using here 2D space. If value for m is 3, it means 3D. So it depends the number of dimension you want to use. Then we have beta, that is 1.5. you can see this value is greater than 1 and less than 2. So value must be in between 1 and 2. Now here we will put the values. Value for beta we have 1.5. Put the value here and we obtain 0.9400 divided by 1.6169. After that you can see its power we have 1 divided by beta. Put again value for beta 1.5. So after this calculation we have sigma u value, that is 0.6966. So now the value for sigma u is calculated. After that we calculate the step length. Here we have u and v, they are normally distributed, and here each u has a mean of 0 and standard deviation of sigma u. So in the Lewis flight we have two important phases. First we select the random direction. After that we will generate the step that follow Lewis distribution. So here you can see u and v values, they are normally distributed. Here u represent random jump distance and v represent the random direction modifier for both dimension. So here we represent a 2D space. So you can see we have two values for u and two values for v. So the first value for the u, it represent the jump distance for x, and this value represent the jump distance for y, and this value for b, it represent the direction modifier for x, and it represent the direction modifier for y. For example, you can see here we have xy plane. So you can see in the 2D space, here you can see the Lewis flight calculated in the 2D plane. So we are calculating the first step, and we have a two-dimensional space. You can see x and y. So here first value of u, jump distance, that is the jump distance from x, and the second value of u is the jump distance from y. Suppose this is the point, so jump distance from x and jump distance for y. Like that we have two values for v. So first value of v is the direction modifier for x, and then we have second value for v, that is the direction modifier for y. So like that each step is calculated in the Lewis flight. For example, you can see the value is calculated. So these values are just the random values. So for u and v, we randomly distributed the values. After that, we'll put these values here in the step size, in the step length calculation. And you can see we obtain the first step length, that is this one. You can see the sigma v value is already 1, so we will not calculate this value. We will calculate just the sigma u value. So like that we will calculate the second step. Suppose we obtain the sigma v u value this time 0.8325, and after that we'll put the values here and we calculated the second step. You can see here this one. So like that each step is calculated in the Lewis flight. Here you can see this is the Lewis flight path in two dimensional space. You can see the step we calculated. Like that we will calculate other steps in the Lewis flight. You can see here, so we can use Lewis flight in algorithm for efficient exploration to prevent algorithm stuck in the local optima and for the better solution, because you can see here they're using long jumps and also the small ones that help the algorithm to jump out of local optima. And you can see it is also covering the wider search space. So here it can help algorithm to find the optimal solution. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.